Earlier this week, I talked with Sam Seder from Ring of Fire Radio about the issue of Republican governors trying to refuse Syrian refugees. So let's go now to that interview.
The horrible attacks in Paris over last weekend now, I guess, that reverberated throughout the week. At least 129 dead, over 300 injured, almost 100 of whom were critically injured. And Paris, rightfully so, is afraid. They have been attacked twice in 1 year, at least substantially so, with the Charlie Hebdo attacks happening in January of this year. They had been on full red alert since January. They had received multiple warnings. They were still unable, despite the fact that they have rolled back civil liberties. They have extensive surveillance and spying going on of their communications. Paris was unable to prevent this attack. I mean, we can anticipate more attacks in the future and not just in Paris and in France, I would presume, but in other countries, perhaps even ours. So it is that much more disheartening to see that in some ways, at least parts of this country have learned nothing in terms of the response in how to respond to this after 2001 and really another disastrous over a decade, longer than a decade wars in two different countries. And now we're seeing Republican governors in the height of irrationality trying to make hay off of some type of, Islamophobia, would you call it? Syrianophobia? I mean, just fear, really. Fear-mongering.
It is. And that's what the Republican Party, for the most part, does better than anyone else, is drum up this fear. And now, once again, just like after 9/11, they have a group to make us be afraid of. And that's what these Republican governors are trying to do. They're saying, look, we're not going to take any Syrian refugees. You're not going to let them into my state. Absolutely not. But if you do, let's make sure we only bring over the Christian refugees. I mean, they are turning this into a war on religion. It's not the one that they always claim, where Christians are being persecuted here. So what they've done is what they need to do to build their political capital, which is to give this conflict a figurehead. Because as we know with ISIS, there's no apparent leader. I mean, we don't know who is in charge. We don't have an enemy as we did with Osama bin Laden. So these Republican governors are now making these Syrian refugees, these people trying to flee ISIS, into that figurehead. These are the people to be afraid of because we don't know. We could bring 10,000 over and there could be one terrorist in there that could kill, you know, tens of thousands of people. We don't know. And that's what they keep saying, is we don't know. But it just goes back. This is to get the fear level in America back up, because we're in a presidential election year now. We've got less than a year, and we've got to get that fear, because that fear is going to help us keep our governorships. It's going to help us keep the Senate, keep the House, and win the presidency. And these Republicans know that the base has already been ginned up with the anti-immigrant rhetoric. And now this anti-Islam rhetoric, which was already going on long before these attacks, is going to hit this fever pitch. It's building on what they've already been saying. And now they're using Paris as an excuse, really.
Well, I mean, let's talk about just how stupid this idea of a governor coming out and saying we're not going to allow any Syrian refugees in our state is. And the idea, like you say, of I think it was Rupert Murdoch, who first suggested that we only allow in verified Christians. All right. So first off, and it's embarrassing to have to walk people through this, but in this country, we do not have checkpoints at state borders. And so if a Syrian refugee is allowed into the United States of America, there is no ability for a governor to prevent that person from entering into their state. There is no constitutional authority, and there's no practical ability to do so. So that's just an example of just how stupid the proclamation by these governors are, and how stupid, frankly, anybody who abides by it or actually takes faith in it. Two, the idea that we could verify someone's Christianity, but we can't verify whether or not they're a member of ISIS is absolutely ridiculous and stupid on its face. Three, people should know that to the extent that we've let in Syrian refugees, and we have only allowed in 1,900 over the last 4 years. So you're going to hear people talk about, we've got to do something about the Syrian who have been killed, hundreds of thousands. We've got to do something about the refugee crisis that is destabilizing Europe. Hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of refugees. We have let in 1,900 over 4 years. President Obama's only offered to let in 10,000. This is absurd. We should be ashamed. We should be ashamed as a country. You know, they turned back Jews who were trying to escape Nazi Germany in the 1930s in this country. And because they were afraid that they were going to be Nazi infiltrators. I mean, the bottom line is that this idea that you would turn back Syrian refugees. Now, I suppose it's perfectly rational to try and vet people, and I think we can be pretty effective in doing so. But, you know, when you're talking about right now, of the 1,900 we have let in, less than 2% are of are male and of military age. So, I mean, the bottom line is this is just rampant warmongering. It is rampant hate. And anybody who participates in this is really, I just think, just an out-and-out bigot.